books on social media, some research papers, not exactly the research papers, but what companies call them as white papers and orange papers. They came out with all those stuff, and it was moving fast. So the world then realized that social media and digital mediums holds importance in businesses also. So my presentation today on this occasion would be business digitalization. Now, what is digitalization? Is like everybody would be aware about what's digitalization, but still I've put up a small PPT over here to make you realize and make yourself aware that where the world is standing, what the world is doing, and where we are. So I've put up all my knowledge sharing over here, and to just brief you about what I did after my PhD was I started gaining a lot of queries from, because I was very much active on Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, and all those platforms for my PhD thesis and all, because I was curious to know about how businesses are doing social media, how consumers are perceiving brands and advertisements on social media. So a lot of queries came on LinkedIn that how to use social media for business and all those stuff. So I took that opportunity, started consulting them on free cost basis, that to test my knowledge also, that are my knowledge which I've gained through all these years, I wanted to test it, that is it is working in businesses or not. So slowly and slowly, like starting with the small businesses all over the globe, I received quite good remarks from the businesses and brands that your consulting or your advices are being helpful. That is the reason I founded Convophilia Communications, and a very inspiring story behind Convophilia is also there, that Convophilia is not an English word at all. Like I framed it, I coined it from two different words. Convo is a short form of conversation, and it starts with K because K is my name's initial, Khushbu. And philia is a Greek word for love and friendship. So love for conversations is what means by convophilia. So like social media is not like an engine where you like get an overnight success. No, you have to have a network, you have to build rapport, you have to build relationship, you have to converse with people, your customers, your stakeholders, and all those people, and then later on, like gradually, you'll reap benefits from social media. So that is how Convophilia was formed, and right now currently I'm involved in a lot of projects where I give my strategic consulting to businesses about social media, about digital marketing, and I also do a lot of workshops and seminars, and go even to the institutes to teach students, to institutes like PDPU and all. So my motive in life now is to, whatever knowledge I'm gaining throughout these years or I'm about to gain, is to share with people that how social media can be used profitably, effectively, in the business scenario. And in that process, I also wrote a book which Saiba mentioned in my introduction, that it's called Weave Model, which is also five fundamental principles. If you weave those principles into your business strategies or business mission and vision and all those aspects which are very, very crucial, you ought to get success in social media. So today's topic would be business digitization, new way of doing marketing. Where should it be pointing? I have to click here, that will be easy, I guess. To talk about the trend of digitization, I would just make a small introduction that by the year 2020, an entire generation, Generation C, which we call as connected generation, which is 24/7 connected, will have grown up in a primarily digital world. We have learned computers, we have learned from others the computers, but now the generation is, if you see our relative's child or someone else, they are, at the time of when they have to play with toys, they are playing with mobile phones. And they actually know how to take videos. They actually go onto YouTube and see videos. So we are amazed by this digitized world where children, we don't have to teach them anything. They are just have this inborn capabilities. So now it's not far away where the world would be in this scenario where everyone would be primarily born in digital world. Computers, the internet, mobile phones, texting, social networking are all second nature to these members of this group. Okay, it's just like second nature. Like we do brush or like we bath, it's like digitization for them. They don't have to learn anything. And their familiarity with technology. They're so much tech savvy. Reliance on mobile communications. And desire to remain in contact with large networks of family members, friends and business contacts will transform how we work and how we consume. So, we are talking about the target audience that we are going to cater to. So, if we are going to cater to these kind of people, it obviously makes sense that we, our businesses has to be digitized. Okay? And later in the process of this PPT, I can show you the ways how you can make your businesses digitized, be it any industry. The effects of an increasingly digitized world are now reaching into every corner of life because three forces are powerfully enforcing one another. These three forces are, first is consumer pull. Okay, what's the consumer pull is that? Consumers are particularly Generation C, for example, what we call as extremely connected, 24/7 connected consumers who sleeps after checking their WhatsApp messages and also wakes up and the first thing that they do is check their mobile phones, right? So these kinds of customers are fully adapted with the digital environment. They naturally expect to be always connected, are willing to share. They share their entire life with the world, personal data, and more likely to trust referrals from their closest friends rather than well-known personalities. Like we have all become smart through our smartphones. Like we are actually aware that Aishwarya Rai might not use L'Oreal as a shampoo, but still we use it because maybe we like that brand or we are loyal to that brand or someone else have referred to us. Okay, our friends might have referred to us that okay, this product is suits my hair and it's very good and that's why probably I'm using, not because of Aishwarya Rai. So that is the reason that referrals, like social referrals, work more rather than celebrity endorsements. Technology push. So that is what consumer pull is. They pull out all the data. Even when they go to malls like Spencer's or Reliance Trends and everything else, they search for the product online. When they see something new, they'll go on, they'll Google it out, they will scan the barcode and check all the details and features of the products right in the store. And it's amazing to know that some researches have been shown that people change their purchase decisions while in the store. Right? While they are going to buy something else, but they come out with another product, another company's brand. So this is how influences are making changes in purchase decisions of people. So that's consumer pull is one factor. Another factor is technology push. You know, constantly you are receiving a technology push in your life, which is digital technology continues to expand its influence. The infrastructure backbone of digital world is bringing affordable broadband to billions of consumers. The recent example is Jio. Okay, a lot of people had free internet. What all we did with that free internet, right? And actually Jio, hooked us onto digitalization, like being digital all the time. Consumers in the parallel, low-cost connected devices. Smartphones have become so much low cost. Smartphones like Oppo, Vivo, Micromax, all those things. have been deployed in every industry. Cloud computing and the vast information process machinery it requires for developing quickly apps and all. So these things are actually making your life very easy. Okay, devices have become cheap. The internet, the connection and the connectivity is being given to you 24/7. So this is a technology push given to you. And the third is economic benefits. The economic benefits to be captured through digitalization are real. A wave of capital has poured into the new digitalization technologies, and companies and the public markets reward early movers with unprecedented valuations. So there are a lot of economic benefits. What are these? Let me take you to the next slide. These I was talking is exploring the mega trends. If you talk about, you know, every industry, there's a B2B industry is in there, that B2C industries is there, connectivity and convergence, mega trends impacting businesses, societies, economies, cultures and personal lives. So if you're not able to see, there's first is future infrastructure development, health, wellness and well-being, hospitals and hospitality industry, investing to zero, there's zero waste and all those stuff, future of mobility, economy that is beyond bricks, connectivity and convergence, future of energy. If you also want to, you know, smallest thing like paying bills has become digitized, urbanization, social trends, smart is the new creation, smart is the new green, sorry, bricks and clicks, new business models. So all these mega trends are now changing how the people were doing business and are now doing businesses. Evaluate areas of impact, like how to go about digitized. If I may just roughly ask in this room, how many of you are into B2B kinds of industry? Okay, B2C, any service providers? Right. So if we talk about every kind of industry and each and every business, if you are an entrepreneur or if you're working in an organization, whatever your situation or position is, like it will, digitalization is will hit you, and how you will manage that digitization is how to evaluate these areas of impact. Now what these impacts of areas are: business models, operational processes and workplaces. First of all, if we take about business models, let me just give you a very simple example of taxis and Ubers or Olas. How many of have used Ubers and Olas? Everyone?
Most of.
So we are now used to these services rather than calling a taxi or going out and, you know, if it is a small city, we'll go out and catch an auto. Okay, as simple as that. Even Ola offers auto services too. So that is what is business disruption. People have started getting things from each other rather than MNCs and government. Okay, they've started renting stuff. And that's why there's a whole lot of concept of sharing economy. Okay, people have started sharing things, money, spaces. If we talk about spaces, I'll give you an example of co-working spaces. Okay, so there's these kinds of business disruption. Disruption has already been begun, and new startups and new business models have started come. See, if you are not going to dive into this digitization and make your business or organization digitized, then tomorrow some other startup would come up and be in your same industry, offer the same product but in a digitized way, which is very much user friendly. So it's better that you adopt the digitization and make your whole business digitized, whether it's processes, whether it's product or whether it's service, right? So if we talk about business models, there's new services you can offer with the old product or your existing product, you can offer something new which is very, very user friendly, which gives your user a new experience. Okay, people right now are talking about experiences rather than product. Okay, even in travel industry, they are not booking a holiday, they are booking an experience, like overall experience. Even if we talk about a simplest thing of birthdays and anniversaries, okay, new services, just like day before yesterday, I went to see a movie in INOX, and INOX have came out with this cards, gift cards, which you can gift to, and there's a beautiful message written on it, happy birthday, anniversary, and two other messages, that you don't only gift a physical gift to someone, it's like an experience. You giving someone an experience to just go get relaxed, have a movie and dinner with your loved ones, and that's it. That's the best gift ever that one can give to another.
It's a gift a movie.
Gift a movie. Yes, yes. Gift a movie. So it's a beautiful, it also builds a beautiful relationship between that two people. Okay? So that is the thing which, when we talk about new service, what new ways, digitized ways you are giving to your users. Customer experience, that's what I talked about. E-marketing communications, how you are communicating your messages on digital and social media. Like, gone are the days where there was an option of being on social media or not. Okay, now you have to have your presence on social media, and it's up to you how you're going to make it, either through content marketing, either through just presence, awareness, make some strategies and all those stuff I'll come on later, but there's now no option. You have to be on social media. Other thing is payment model. Paytm has made a huge changes in our lives. It has become so much easy to transfer funds right now. Even banks have adopted this. Like, just imagine the scenario if banks would not have become digitized. If you do not have an ICICI app or Axis Bank's app on your mobile phone. Just imagine the situation. So it was on the right time when even banks, came on to the digitization route. And obviously it has to have become, because the wave of technology is that way. Omnichannel. So now every business is not on even single channel or multi-channel, but it's omni-channel. Like, if you understand the meaning of omnipresence, it's present everywhere. So wherever you go, wherever you want your business to go, people has to realize that you are there, very much there. Okay, there's a difference between there and very much there. Like, you have a Facebook page, but you don't connect. You don't post anything, or you post once in a while, like once in a month, you don't engage with people. And there's another situation where there's a business page or Facebook page on of a business, and you engage people, and people are actually trying to connect with you, talk with you, give their feedback, and they are actually giving their criticisms, like constructive criticism, what sir talked about. This will help you take your business to the next level. That is all about business models. Second thing is how to be in the wave of digitization through operational processes. Lean processes, supply chain or logistics, Internet of Things, governance and monitoring, inventory management, big data, all these are examples of how and where you can make your business processes digitized. And the thing is, other thing is workplace. How much your workplace is digitized. Communication, how you are communicating. If I talk about communication, a simple example would be Facebook for workplace. How many of the people here have used Facebook for workplace? If I may, can ask you, sir, what's your experience about Facebook for workplace?
Facebook, I didn't get really good response.
Okay.
On LinkedIn,
Right.
They're getting very good response.
Exactly, because your target audience might be on LinkedIn.
Yeah.
So this is also a very important point which sir had made, is that follow where your target audience are. Other than following the blind route pathway that, okay, Facebook is very, very famous, I may get business over there, let's be on Facebook. No. If your target audience is not on Facebook, if they are not using Facebook so constant, because even Facebook, you know, is for some social space. Okay, people want to connect to their friends, family. They don't want to do business like every 24/7. They also want to have a personal space. So might be a scenario. So you have to do a little bit of research that where your customers are, where they are talking productively about your business or your industry or being a thought process leader. So I was talking about Facebook for workplace. It's on social networking for businesses. If it is working for you, it's a very beautiful product made by Facebook, where there's a whole scenario of social networking which it can be used for communication amongst your employees, your business people, and everybody who you want to make in that group. That's one thing. Other thing is training. How you're making your trainings digitized, okay? How you're taking feedbacks of your people. Those things can be discussed over here. Infrastructure, mobility, and applications. Applications like mobile applications, if they are making your work easier, then you should definitely develop one. But if you think that, okay, if it's not so much applicable in my business, then you shouldn't do for it. So for each of this digitization decisions that you going to make for your company, firstly you have to sit, think and plan. What I was hearing very briefly over there was that you have to plan this whole process, that is this going in line with my business decisions? Is this going in line with my business visions? Okay, and how I can make it work for my customers or users? And then you have to go ahead with it. This is the, you know, kind of scenario which you can get after digitization. So if you talk about new business models, there's these three things. There's connectivity is the key enabler. You have to connect each and every part of your business. It's not only the marketing thing when we talk about social media. You have to include people from your production. You have to include people from your HR. You have to include people from your sales, marketing, promotions, branding, designing, everyone. Because social media is not one man's job. It's everybody's, you know, job. And if at all, let's take a simple scenario, there's a business of 100 people or 1,000 people, okay? You will write something about social media, about your job, that my boss is not good with me and this and that. Somebody else would perceive that the work culture of your company is not good, and that is why you're always frustrated, and that actually is disturbing your company's reputation on social media. So the culture inside the company also has to be made very, very positive if you want to, you know, reflect your company positive on social media. So it's not about one man's or one team's job. It's everybody's job to make your business, you know, look good on social media, and look good in real sense. Like not saying goody-goody stuff just like that, but meaning those stuff and making that changes inside that organization. Product as a service. Okay, one simple example that I would state over here is like is of BMW. Like BMW started with an app called Drive Now app, which allowed its users and allowed other users to use BMW as a service rather than a product. If I don't have money, if I don't have enough funds to buy a BMW, I can simply rent a BMW. and use for my simplest occasions, like occasions that are very important in my life, like birthdays, anniversaries or marriages, where people would love to use such services and take the pleasure of, you know, receiving that services. So it's not always a product as an offering, it's also product as a service offering. So that's what we mean by digitization. And other things are disruptive innovation. When I talk about Ubers and Olas, they are nothing else but the disruptive innovations that have come from the problems where people would find certain simplest solutions, like driving. If somebody have heard about My Bike service, My Bike, which is running in Ahmedabad. So it's a very simple solution where I want to go to certain place. I have a vehicle, but I'm afraid of traffic. I don't want to take my long car and just drive to a certain place where where I know that I'm not going to get a parking. So I just use, if I'm a bike cycle enthusiast, only then I'll use that service. I'll rent a bike. I'll go to a certain transportation facility which is BRTS or some bus stand. I'll sit on that BRTS. I'll go to a certain route. Again, I'll hire. That service is pre-taken, so you don't have to. You can take any of the bicycle. You again take a bicycle. You go to a certain place. Use that service, and the same route you come home, and your work is done. Okay. So these are the services which are actually disrupting the traditional way of doing businesses. The 10 most valuable startups globally are estimated to have a value of $172.7 billion. Xiaomi and Uber alone account for more than 50% of the top 10 startups. So you can imagine the situation, or imagine the, you know, the things that disruptive businesses are doing. One very good example also, if you can relate over here, is that about Lego pieces, L-E-G-O, which kids you play, right? Everybody aware about Lego,
yeah.
Right? So, and they are a bit expensive. Whole Lego sets are very expensive. So if your child, or if you can't afford your child to give him or gift him a Lego set, you can just rent out. There's a portal, there's an app present over there where families rent out their Lego, because their kids might have become more younger, they don't no more use these Lego pieces. So they offer there at a very minimal price, and other families who wants to rent out can rent there as a this thing. So that's the middle thing that you in this scenario, the app or that platform is actually disrupting the way of doing business. So people are not actually buying new sets, but they are renting out the old Lego sets. So this is how.
It's kind of a library.
It's kind of a library.
Library of size company.
Yes, yes. I'm just quoting. E-libraries have also started. So I'm quoting examples which are not prevalent in India to give an impression that where we are actually and what more we can do, right? So these actually are happening way back. Like these services have been started 2-3 years back, or maybe more, outside India. It's happening somewhere else. So why not take these examples and create our own examples in our businesses, that how we can be disruptive, how we can make our businesses disruptive, discarding the as many as possible the middlemen, if we can, through digitization. Other things are under new operational processes can be agile manufacturing future. If I can read, the 3D printing is a new services, saves 40-65% on energy as it eliminates shipping and other logistics activities and enables users to produce objects with less material. 3D printing also reflects up to 70% savings due to prototyping costs. Other thing is Internet of Industrial Things. Predictive intelligence platforms in industries are helping companies to increase their production line, making it 30% faster along with significant cost saving. And the last thing is big data in retail. Okay, all might obviously might have heard about big data. So big data analytics allows retailers which make use of big data to increase revenue margins by more than 60%. And if we talk about new workplaces, the new trend right now going on is virtual office. Many businesses in the West have stopped their physical offices and have given freedom to their employees to work from virtual offices. So working from anywhere, anytime concept of work will result in decrease in office space. Obviously, your infrastructure cost would be saved. From 178 square meters in 2013 to 128 square meters in 2022, thereby resulting an increase in the utilization rate from 55% to 80%. So that this is this fact data that I'm giving just to quote an example of how people are relying upon virtual offices. An employee 2.0. With the workforce expected to be agile, adaptable and connected through virtual space technology and BYOD strategies, future employees will be more productive working between 5 to 7 hours in a day. And that's, these all are the trending things or mega trends if we talk about in the digitalization world. A very simple example to quote here, how will digitalization work in travel industry? So a travel company can provide location-based services such as developing mobile applications that we already are seeing of some of the applications like Make My Trip and all, that provide travel-friendly navigational information, shortest path to reach nearest hospitals like we see in Google, restaurants in a new city and country, all those stuff. If one is an avid trekker or wildlife photographer, he can benefit from an app that gives all the information on a species of flora or fauna in minutes after scanning a picture the person has just taken from his mobile phone. So this is a very simplest application feature which even a travel industry agents, whether it's a travel booking firm or it's a hotel firm or any of the travel industry people can adopt these kinds of new innovations and give something extra rather than just offering hotel rooms or taxis or a holiday package. Okay, something because people now wants more, something more. Biju su apo chhani jode, right? Every time people will ask you this question, and even we ask to people when we go somewhere else, like we ask for discounts, we ask for something new, we ask for free items, we ask for lot many things. So the same way, why not to give people something extra and grab their attention in this digitized world, which would be very much easy rather than before. Like giving newspaper advertisement, it is now very very easy to just invite people on your Facebook page or on a tweet chat or something like that and offer them a new way or new product or new service or new experience. Something which is related to your basic product or service. These are some of the examples of each industry that I would like to quote over here just to give an idea about digitization. The first is automotive. So write specifications for an app for truck drivers, for example. Okay, so big automotive industries can do that. And it comes into the impact type one, which is new business model. The other thing is healthcare. Develop an app to advise doctors or pharmacists, patients on medications, big data to drive sales and marketing efforts and evaluate clinical reach. So this already is happening, like Practo, if you have heard about an app called Practo, right? So these kinds of applications are in business, but what if, you know, doctors themselves develop something to be in touch with their patient and with the druggist or pharmacist, which would ease their work, Okay. So these kinds of applications are obviously been happening in big cities, like big hospitals, and doctors are being doing this.
If you talk about aerospace, implement multi-size teamwork practices. If you talk about energy, develop value propositions and test new services based on connected devices. Develop an app for shareholders. If you talk about industrial, develop value propositions and test new services based on connected machines. Define with suppliers new processes through connectivity. If you talk about banks, coach managers to multi-site and multicultural work. And if you talk about public sector, elaborate complex government digitization roadmap and scope first wave of high impact digitization projects. So these are the examples of all the industries.
And the last thing that I would like to talk about is marketing in this age of digitization. There are lots of tools available. The four things very, very important, which I have listed over here from my past experiences, is first is digital marketing. Digital marketing is not only website marketing or SEO or PPC or CPC, all this stuff you would be, you know, quite often hearing from all the people, from your marketing manager or from your marketing outsourced company. Okay, but digital marketing is a way of marketing where you put your business on a digital roadmap and you tell your customers that you are there, very much there, to provide service, after sales service, or anything that your customers are wanting from. And these are the tools which you can then adopt. Like having a website is very, very important. Like even now brands, other than brands, even people have started up above their, you know, as their second home on internet. Next is social media. Obviously social media is a subset of digital marketing. It's a tool where you know, people can just make their audience talk to about their businesses. If customers are talking about your business, you should definitely know, and that's called social listening. Okay, somewhere in Calcutta or Pune, if anybody is talking about Convophilia Communications, I should know that they are talking about me. And how would I know is through social listening tools. Okay, there are a lot of tools, free and paid, which you can use. Like Social Mention is a free tool where you can just you know, search that where you are talked about, and then you can go into that, interrupt that conversation and offer them. If it is a query, you can write your solution over there. If it is a complaint, you tell them how to, you know, just delight that customer, and all those are strategies that you can provide. But you should definitely know first, is that important point. Third is content marketing. The things that I'm speaking over here is also a content which is being recorded, which is being, you know, taken live on Facebook Live. Like Saiba told me that it's been a Facebook Live. That is a content for me. Okay. Now, whenever I would get another invites or you know, speaking opportunities, this is a content for me where people are listening me, and I can showcase to the world that okay, I was being invited over here, and this is my resume, like digitized resume, which is very, very real on real time basis. And from these, you know, people can gauge that okay, what I'm capable of and what I'm not. So this is the content marketing step, which can be on various ways. It can be text, it can be visuals, it can be videos, it can be live, it can be stories, because this is a year of stories which I talk about. Snapchat came with stories, but later on Instagram stories, WhatsApp stories, Facebook stories. Right, people are creating stories everywhere, and that's how people are creating content everywhere. So content marketing is also, you know, a tool which businesses can use for, you know, marketing. And the last is influencer marketing. Have anybody heard about influencer marketing? Any idea about what's influencer marketing? Okay, So I'll just share a very small example which I shared at the start of my presentation about Aishwarya Rai. Right? So if I have 5,000 plus followers on Twitter, and I am very much speaking about social media, new media marketing, business processes, internet marketing and all those stuff. So I'm known for those things because I'm doctorate, my education is on that field, and people trust me that whatever I will advise would be making difference to them. So if I tweet something bad about some company, it would make a bad influence about that company. So people are trusting influential, socially influential people rather than some celebrities. So that is how brands are doing influencer marketing. They are now not hiring much like small brands and even startups. They are not hiring celebrities. They are hiring influencers, and that's how they are making a new change in their marketing strategy. They are hiring people with 10,000 plus, 20,000 plus, 50,000 plus network of social media. Either Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn, whatever works with you. Whatever works in your business. They are hiring those kinds of people. They are spreading their communication messages from those kind of people. Okay, and it's also very important that you hire right kind of influencer. If you are hiring a food blogger to talk about technology, people will not believe. Right? So if you want to talk about your new restaurant, you will have to hire a food blogger who is known for his food concepts or her food ideas. You know, people trust her taste buds. And if they suggest that, okay, this restaurant is very, very good, you should definitely go and try it, people would definitely catch on to that. Okay? So this is what, in a simplest way, influencer marketing is. So these are the new trends right now going on in the digitization world if you talk about marketing. Right? So if you want to just have digitalization process going on in your marketing department, or if you have hired any marketing agency, these are the things that you should ask them, that are we doing this stuff? Are these stuff needed in my business? If yes, then how we are going to do this stuff? Digitization helps an organization to be more alert to changing business values, customize products and responses with clients on a personal level, and most importantly, to streamline and automate all processes that workers can focus on things that really matter most in business, and that is human touch. In short, we can say to increase the presence of a company in society and in turn raise more awareness and goodwill in the environment, digitization really is the lifeline of any business. So if you want to really show what your business is, you should stop thinking about do you want to go on social media platforms or on digital world. You should stop thinking about that. Rather, you should start making a plan that how your business you want to project on these channels, what's going on offline, and how you would project those offline work online. Okay, so this is the whole short and crisp information that I thought to put out for today's session on business digitization. Thank you very much.